Hey everyone, welcome to English SOS. 今日咧就同大家分享一下八个好多时喺公司文件同埋 email 里面会见到嘅错误。咁喺香港咧，好多时见到唔同嘅公司上嘅 email 或者文件咧，都会见到同样嘅错误嘅。咁我相信好多时系见到人哋用，咁自己咧就攞埋嚟用，咁但其实唔知道其实嗰样嘢咧系唔正确嘅。咁今日咧就希望大家睇完呢个影片之后咧，就可以改翻呢八个唔同嘅错误。第一呢、這个句子 ，Your email is well received。嗱 ，well received 唔系想话俾人听你收到 ，well received 其实系一个形容词，个意思系个反应好好。咁佢正确嘅用法咧，就可能会系好似以下嘅句子咁样嘅。Her new book was well received by adults as well as children. Her new book was well received by adults as well as children. 佢本新嘅书咧，对小朋友同埋大人咧都系好受欢迎嘅。咁其实如果你想讲话我收到你封 email， 其实你有几个唔同嘅讲法嘅。第一 ，thank you for your email。Thank you for your email。第二 ，thank you for your prompt reply。Thank you for your prompt reply. 第三 ，Your timely response is greatly appreciated. Your timely response is greatly appreciated. 咁如果其實你唔需要多謝人哋嘅，你只係純粹話俾人聽，你真係收到咧，你可以用以下呢兩句嘅。This is to acknowledge the receipt of your email. This is to acknowledge the receipt of your email. Your email has been received and forwarded to the relevant department.Your email has been received and forwarded to the relevant department. 第二个错误 ,please revert as soon as possible. Revert 这个字不是代表回复 ,revert 这个字是代表回到去一个之前的状态。所以在这里用 revert 是不正确的。如果你想人家回复其实你可以用 respond 或者 reply。例如 ,please respond at your earliest convenience.Please respond at your earliest convenience. 第二 I look forward to your reply. I look forward to your reply. 咁其實 respond 同埋 reply 有啲咩唔一樣呢？嗱，咁其實 respond 咧係根據內容去回覆，即係人哋問你一啲嘢，你就去回覆翻嗰個內容。而 reply 純粹係一個回覆翻信件嘅動作。第三 ，please God kindly。其實兩個字咧都係有禮貌嘅字嚟嘅，不過就唔好將佢一齊用啦，因為會多得滯。例如 ，please kindly provide an updated quotation for us。咁呢度咧就多得滯啦，嗰個禮貌。咁如果我想正確表達呢樣嘢咧，我可以睇下以下呢個例子嘅。Please provide an updated quotation for us at your earliest convenience。Please provide an updated quotation for us at your earliest convenience. 第二 ,would you kindly provide an updated quotation for us? Would you kindly provide an updated quotation for us? 呢度值得留意嘅呢就係当我哋用禮貌嘅英文去表达一啲嘢嘅时候呢好多时呢就会用问题嘅方式呢去叫人帮我哋做嘢嘅。咁第三个选择呢就係 ,we would appreciate it if you could provide an updated quotation for us.We would appreciate it if you could provide an updated quotation for us. 第四个错误 ,discuss about. 咁其实 discuss 呢一个动词呢佢係一个 transitive verb, 及物动词。即係话你 discuss, 你讨论嗰样嘢呢可以直接将嗰个字放喺 discuss 后面就唔需要 about 呢一个介词嘅。咁 discuss 个用法呢就会似以下嘅格式嘅。discuss something with someone.就是傾一啲嘢就同邊一個人嘅。咁我首先講個錯誤嘅例子俾大家聽。Let's discuss about the details of the project。咁呢一個咧就係錯誤嘅，因為唔應該有 about。咁正確嘅例子咧就會係 Let's discuss the details of the project with him tomorrow。Let's discuss the details of the project with him tomorrow。第五 ，I really appreciate。咁好多人咧會用呢一句咧去表達我好感激你幫我做嘅嘢嘅。咁但係其實 appreciate。感激呢一个用法咧，佢亦都系一个 transitive verb 及物动词，即系话你一定要俾个受词 object 俾佢嘅。所以呢一句咧就应该系 I really appreciate it。I really appreciate it。嗱，咁其实当然读得快咧 ，appreciate 嘅过去式 appreciated 同埋 appreciate 加 it 嘅读法咧都系一样嘅，都系 appreciated。咁所以咧。当你讲嘅时候或者你写嘅时候呢你就要注意究竟你系想写 IT, 还是你系想写 ED 啦。咁俾两个例子大家。第一 ,I truly appreciate it。 I truly appreciate it. Your assistance on this matter is appreciated. Your assistance on this matter is appreciated. 第六個錯誤係一啲請人嘅 post 上面咧，我會見到 immediate available preferred， 即係話你想嗰個人盡快可以嚟翻工嘅。跟住呢一度嘅錯誤咧，就係唔應該用 available， 因為 immediate 呢一個字即時佢本身咧係一個 adjective 形容詞嚟嘅。咁喺呢一度咧 ，available 可用亦都係一個形容詞嚟嘅。咁其實係冇意思，你唔應該將兩個形容詞放埋一齊。咁呢一度咧，我哋就應該用 available 嘅名詞嘅形態啦，即係 availability 咁樣咧先至正確嘅。咁呢一句嘅正確嘅表達方式咧，就應該係 immediate availability preferred。immediate availability preferred。咁如果一個人咧想話俾人聽，其實我即刻就可以翻工噶啦，你咧就可以話 I am immediately available。I am immediately available。咁喺呢一個句子裏面咧 ，immediately 咧就係嗰個副詞 adverb， 而之後咧我哋就有 available 嘅形容詞啦。第七個錯誤 ，the proposal is very details。咁呢一度咧好多時啲人想用 details 呢一個字咧去形容好多細節或者好多唔同嘅資訊嘅。咁其實 detail 呢一個字咧，佢可以係一個名詞嚟嘅。咁喺呢一度咧就唔係好合理啦。你用 details 呢一度，如果我想講話很多細節的。我咧就應該用 detailed 就有 ed 味嘅。例子 ，please provide a detailed description of the product。Please provide a detailed description of the product。第二個例子 ，the description is too detailed for our needs。The description is too detailed for our needs。第八個錯誤 ，the below instructions。咁好多人咧想用 the below instructions 去代表以下嘅指示。咁其實 below 呢個字咧有兩個唔同嘅用法嘅。第一，佢係一個副詞 adverb 個用法咧就會係咁嘅。Please see the instructions below。Please see the instructions below。佢咧就應該出現喺個 instructions 嘅後面，而唔係喺佢前面嘅。呢一個錯誤咧，我就算喺我啲中學生嘅學校嘅試卷裏面咧，我都會見到嘅。咁我覺得咧係好離譜嘅。咁 below 有第二個用法嘅，就係一個 preposition， 一個介詞。咁佢後面咧就會係一個名詞嚟嘅。咁個用法嘅意思咧就係佢喺乜嘢以下。例子 ，His exam results are below average。His exam results are below average。咁希望呢個 lesson 幫到大家啦。咁大家記住喺工作嘅時候，你打公司嘅 email 或者文件咧，就唔好再犯呢啲錯誤啦。如果大家喜歡呢個 video 嘅話咧，就歡迎 subscribe 個 YouTube channel， 亦都歡迎 follow 個 IG 同 Facebook 嘅。咁如果大家仲有啲咩唔明咧，就歡迎留言俾我，亦都可以 send 個 email 俾我嘅。咁如果大家需要一位私人英文補習老師咧，亦都歡迎 send 個 email 俾我。Thank you and see you next time。